Krishnaya, Krishna Prema Pradayate, Krishnaya, Krishna Chaitanya, Namo Guru Vishnu. He Krishna Karuna Sindhu, Krishna Govinda Jagadipati, Gopesh Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute. Saptakantan Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavani Shri Vishwabhanu Devi Pranamani Te Vrindavani Tulsi Devi Kuryavani Devavachya Krishna Bhakti Pari Devi Satyavati Namo Shri Krishna Chaitanya Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shivasadi Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Five minutes. Will be.
Hamra, Mahaprabhu, Guru Vaishnavar Kripay, Ram Mahaprabhu, Ram Krishna Chandra,
हाँ ये बोल दे यार.
Kripay, Hamra, Krishna.
So he's telling us something about the glories of Srimad Mahaprabhu. So today we went through so many places, and also day before yesterday, and yesterday also, and in the days to come also, we'll be visiting to all the places of Sri Sri Radha Krishna's pastimes and the places associated with those pastimes. So, how we are getting this mercy? This is the mercy of Srimad Mahaprabhu. If it was not for Srimad Mahaprabhu to come here and explore all these places, it would not have been possible for us to come and visit these places and get the mercy. Srimad Mahaprabhu has advented in this world, is come in this world to deliver the fallen souls of this Kali Yuga. Because we are so much fallen, our minds are so weak, our tendencies are so bad, our habits are so bad that we have completely forgotten about our original nature, who we are, where we have come from. We have completely forgotten Krishna. So Srimad Mahaprabhu, seeing that these people, the divinities of this Kali Yuga, these jivas, they do not even understand about their nature. What to speak of knowing the wonderful and the mysterious and the most sweet love of Srimati Radhika for Krishna. This is not possible for them. So mercifully he said, I will do the both things. I will come and by the Naam, by distributing Krishna Naam Kirtan, Hare Krishna Mantra, everyone can come and benefit from this mantra. And he himself tasted the mood of Srimati Radhika, the mood with which she controls Krishna. He tasted that mood himself. And also he has given sprinkles of that love for us. So he made first attempt to come to Braja, because unless he would come to this place and he would not again establish those places of pastime, nobody can understand, because by that time, it was 5,000 years ago, Krishna has performed his pastime, and by this time, all the places were again covered. So when Mahaprabhu came, one by one, he went to all the different places and he again established those places like Radhakund, Shyamakund and all other places. So, in first attempt he was not able to come. Why? Because there were so many more devotees with him. So he wanted to come from the highway, but then all the devotees surrounded him and they did not let Mahaprabhu come to Vrindavan. Then on the advice of Sanatana Goswami Prabhu, Mahaprabhu came to the forest of Jharkhand. And there also, by crossing through the forest, he delivered so many animals, he delivered so many trees and plants and creatures by chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra. And then he came to Braja. So Prabhuji will speak for a few more minutes and then he will take Prasada and go.
Mahaprabhu
Mukura Island, they say
Then he went to, he wanted to discover Radha Kund and Shyam Kund. So he inquired from the local people there, village people, that if they know anything about Radha Kund and Shyam Kund. But nobody could reply anything. But instead they said, yes, we know there is two fields. There are two fields nearby, we know. One is Shyam field, Shyam Khet, another is Gauri Khet. Gauri Khet. So means in one of the fields they were having crops with black complexion, and in another field they were having crops with fair complexion, white complexion. So Mahaprabhu, he immediately understood, must be that it must be the same place. So he said, you take me to those places. So the village people, they took Mahaprabhu to that places. In that field, the Mahaprabhu saw that it was all covered with big crops, but there was little water somewhere. So he saw that water, and just by seeing, he understood that these are the only, these are actually Radha Kund and Shyam Kund. So he bathed at that place, and then he established that he certified that those places are Radha Kund and Shyam Kund. Where later on, by desire of Sri Raghunath Das Goswami Pad, this whole nice arrangement was made. As you know, now we see that. So like this, Mahaprabhu went to many other places, and then when he went back to Puri, he thought in his mind that though I have gone to Mathura and Vrindavan and I have established all these places, but again after some time these places will be covered, will become hidden, because people will not understand the glories of this place. They will not be able to relate themselves to this place. So then he sent the six Goswamis and other devotees, mainly six Goswamis, and he ordered them. They should go and establish deities at particular places relation to their pastime, and he ordered them also to publish scriptures and write books in accordance to those places, and plus stating the principles and doctrines of Gaudiya Sampradaya. So that's how all the six Goswamis have written so many scriptures. And it is very authentic, bona fide and detailed description of Shri Radha Krishna's pastimes and also of Shrimad Mahaprabhu. And we are very fortunate that we are getting that treasure, that unlimited wealth from very bona fide disciplic succession of our gurus, who are so much absorbed in the same virtue which Shrimad Mahaprabhu was in. This is something very special, because in Kalyuga it is impossible. But still we have that. So we must be very much sincere and dedicated, and we must be very much inquisitive and enthusiastic to receive that mercy. And we should dedicate ourselves completely and pray. By coming to these places, we get an opportunity to touch the Dham. And by seeing the Dham Vasis and winning the mercy of the deities, by giving some donation, we solidify our sanskaras, sukriti. That sukriti, then it accumulates to a very big amount. It gives us a very favorable mood, a very favorable intelligence and mind by which we can understand what we are hearing. Otherwise, in the lack of sukritis and sanskaras, it's very difficult for us to advance. Because if we say we'll get causeless mercy, that's true, we can get causeless mercy, but that's very, very rare. Very, very rare. There are hardly any few examples where devotees have got causeless mercy. Most of us, we must do some sadhana, and the basis of sadhana is this sukriti. Because unless we have this sukriti, we cannot perform these devotional activities. Why? We have to carry out these activities through our bodily senses, but we see we are so incomplete. Our senses, they cannot do so much. Our mind does not cooperate. So many problems. Though these are just basic things we have performed. So by coming here, since we have made such a big effort coming all the way from so many far out countries and spending so much money, taking out so much time, so let's very sincerely pray to this place and pray to Shrimad Mahaprabhu and our Goswamis and our Gurus in our Parampara, and pray to all the Dhammasis that they should become kind and compassionate towards us, though we don't have any qualification and we know that we don't deserve these things. But by dint of their causeless mercy, they can make us capable. Because Shrimad Mahaprabhu's mercy is known, that he does not give his mercy, but he also gives the qualification. Those who don't deserve, he makes them deserving. So we have this hope, and with this hope, we continue. to follow this path and go for all of the whole of this month. We go to all those places and pray for the mercy of that place also. God Premanand, Kartik Vrata ke Vrata Palan Kari Bhakta Vrinda ke Shishi Gaur Nityananda Prabhu ke God Premanand. Ramesh Gupta ji ke. This is the devotee who have invited all of us and he's making such a nice arrangement from Prashad and he's with them, so it's nice to have him. All glories to Ramesh Prabhu ji.